Check out this bicycle right here. We'll call that the orange poinsettia bike.
It's all painted orange with a flamingo on there.
You can find the flamingo bikes all over the place in Sarasota.
Yesterday or today, I'm not sure which. Sometime in the middle of this month is my oldest son's birthday.
More on that in a second. There's some little people with some little Segway type vehicles. All kind of interesting things happening today. One of which, let me clean you off for a second. There's some smudges. Whenever the camera is in the sun, I can't see well with the finger smudges on there. That's a little bit better. Interesting thing happened today. Today I woke up in a pretty good mood, but I just, for some reason, I was lagging in energy. I don't know why. That lady was wondering what I was doing with the camera. She was like looking at me because I have my cell phone shooting and I have like a little handle on it, like a little short selfie stick thing. I'd show it to you, but you wouldn't want to see it. So I was feeling a little groggy, so I took some Tylenol with caffeine. That usually kind of gets me up and moving. And I was watching some videos on YouTube, because usually my morning plan is, or my morning thing is, to wake up around 7:30, watch Good Morning America. Here's a swanky building. Bay Plaza. Ooh, swanky. So I watched Good Morning America. My girlfriend left for work, and then I started watching some YouTube videos, and I try to get inspired by sort of watching YouTube. I watch a couple people, Adam the Woo, and I used to watch Casey Neistat, a lot of vlogging type people that basically do what I do. Let me adjust this real quick. Adjust. Better. That's better. A little bit more comfortable. It gets to be a pain when you're holding your camera for like 20 minutes or 15, 20 minutes. Your hand sort of gets crampy. My fingers get cramped easy. So where was I? I sound like an old person sometimes. So then I was watching a YouTube video. I was watching a YouTube video, I think yesterday, on Adam the Woo's channel, about Tom Wilson signing autographs. And he said something to the fact of, Tom Wilson is Biff from Back to the Future, the movie Back to the Future, and Biff, and you know, the guy that harassed the main hero, Michael J. Fox's character. The guy is really funny. And by the way, that movie would have not had much success without Tom Wilson as the bad guy, the villain in the movie. You know, Tom Wilson, the big guy that like tries to beat up Marty McFly, and Marty McFly pushes him down and runs out of the diner and is always trying to grope on Lorraine and all that stuff. A lot of folks hanging out today. Like, this guy's eyeballing me. I don't know why. He's kind of big. And a lot of construction going on. I don't know what that is. Maybe another condo, because we need more condos. Everybody knows we need more condos. So Tom Wilson is an awesome actor, and so I was thinking, the fact that he had a big role as a young guy in the 80s, and then after that you didn't see much of him. Well, he's a successful guy, and he is a comedian, and I think he does stand-up comedy too, as well as doing acting. But he didn't have the luck of Michael J. Fox to where it catapulted him into an A-list actor and kept on going. Not for lack of talent. That smells good there.
Good smell.
I don't know, I think he did some B-movies and stuff. The stuff you've seen him in is probably not some big, huge movies. And he's a very, very funny guy. And I saw some video of him on a Wizard Con, like, convention thing, where he was doing a panel, and Adam the Woo said that he does not sign Back to the Future merchandise, and I don't know why. I haven't got to the bottom. That's why I was watching more videos. His name's Tom. What did I say his name was? Tom Wilson. Yeah, Biff from Back to the Future. That's the role we know him as. He's done stuff since then. He does YouTube vlogs at Tom Wilson on YouTube. just Tom Wilson. He is very, very, very funny. Hilarious. Probably funnier than Michael J. Fox is, probably. This guy actually stopped to let me cross the street. Very nice of him. He's driving a nice car, too. So, have you got your seatbelts on? Because this might be one of those longer vlogs where I don't keep track of the time and I just keep talking and talking and talking. Wow, look at this. This is the Florida Student Theater. Alright, so what happened was I had planned to talk about Tom Wilson, and my message was sort of like talking about being a survivor. Tom Wilson, probably not a wealthy guy, maybe he does a good living and stuff, but he had to move on from Back to the Future fame. Alright, so then I was overshooting this war memorial thing. Video, oh no, battery's low, right? Battery is low. I was afraid of that. I forgot to charge my cell phone. Okay. Battery's low. Hopefully it won't shut off right now. I have a lot to say. Darn it. I need to start being more responsible with cell phones and charging. So, where were we? I'm shooting the War Memorial. There's a lady sort of sleeping on the ground on cardboard. And it's like about 11:30-ish, I think. And I walk around the War Memorial because I'm trying to read it, and she's right next to it, and I scared her, and she woke up, and she started talking to me. The statue is of the Doughboy. The sun's in the way. The World War I soldier, you can tell by the leggings and the helmet. It's kind of got a... I didn't mean... No. And I was just being nice and talking. She's a homeless lady. Very nice lady. And I said, can I ask you a question? And I started talking to her because I've been curious about the homeless situation, like what people's stories are that caused them to. So I said, can I ask you what caused you to be out here? And she said, I got divorced. I was in a car accident. I just spiraled. So anyway, I talked to her for about a half an hour, 20 minutes maybe. And I just asked, and she was very nice and smart and funny. Well, I mean, not funny, but. And so... Because Sarasota has a bit of a homeless problem. There's a lot of people out here, especially like right out here in this park. There's always people seem to gather out here, or by the library over here on the left. And that was not my intent, is to do a vlog on the homeless people, because I keep thinking about it, like I should try to interview somebody, but I think a lot of people are sort of embarrassed by their situation and they don't want... I asked her if she'd take a picture with me and she said no. But anyway, she was on the vlog when I was walking, and she actually started walking behind me and was talking as... She reminds me of a friend of mine's mom. So, to touch on that, my brother is actually homeless, but he receives a disability check, and he has so much more of a choice. Here's the Ring a Bell for Peace bike. This one's been in different areas of town, but there's like an artist guy that does this. So it says Ring a Bell for Peace here, and it's colorfully, why can't I say certain words? Colorfully painted, and you ring a bell for peace. It's just an idea of putting good vibes out there. It's a public, like a free public art. Just put some good vibes in the air, and that's what I hope to do, accomplish somewhat, is by doing these vlogs, I'm sort of putting out some good. The love you make is equal to the love you take, that kind of thing, the karma thing. Putting out good feelings and vibes and things like that. So anyway, I talked to the lady, and she said she had numerous issues with gotten. She last job she had was at a film place, and that she got in a car accident. She had multiple injuries, and it was hard for her to work. As far as I know, she doesn't have a drug issue, but I don't know. I mean, I'm just taking her word for what she said, and I was just sort of quizzing her about like how do you eat and how. And say that she says that people come by and just give you money sometimes. And I asked her. I also asked her if people actually have a place to stay, but they come out here and pretend to be hungry. She's yes. She said yes. That's true. But I think she's basically telling me that she's been off and on homeless for 20 years. And the thing I was telling her is perception is from the general public is that people that are homeless just don't want to work. They're lazy. That's a large part of the perception is. Not that something happened. Take it easy. Take it easy down a little bit there, Sarasota Ford. Dang, dude. You're supposed to slow down for pedestrians, dude. It bugs me when people don't slow down and stop for you. So I tend to stop in the street and be like, hey, you know, just take it easy. It says, pedestrians walking here. This means stop or slow down for pedestrians. In case you don't know, that's what that means. So as a pedestrian, I should be able to walk right here and not have to worry about being hit by a car, because that means stop for people walking. Here's a person right here sitting on the ground with a bike, just kind of hanging out. So I don't have any predisposition against people that don't have homes. I just always wonder, like, what the situation is for that kind of thing. How you doing? People are like cold and they're like hanging out like that, and it's not fun. It's not good. Any way you slice it, you know. Some people choose that situation, and some people do not choose. Hi, dog. Some people do not choose that situation. They're just in that situation. And I think once you're in that homeless situation, it's tough to get out. That's my take on what that's about. So there's some young street gang toughs cruising the neighborhood. I always wonder if those guys are supposed to be in school or not. I'm continuing after I just nearly got ran over in the street where the lady had to slam on her brakes because I was crossing when I had the crosswalk light. So I'm going to put that out of my mind and we're going to continue this conversation. And no, I do not have it on video. Dang it. I need to, every time I cross the street, I just need to roll. You know, the last couple of times I did cross the street, I was rolling just in case, JNK, something happened when I was doing that. And nothing happened, and I wasn't rolling when I crossed Bayfront. And a lady very close to me slammed on her brakes and then yelled at me from her car. But we're moving on from that traumatic experience to finish this vlog. Stay on target. A line from Star Wars, stay on target. Stay on task, stay on theme. So Thomas Wilson, an actor who starred in 3 Back to the Future movies, 1, 2, and 3, was fantastic in my opinion. I really like him. I mean, I haven't seen him in anything, so as far as like, you know, following his career, I don't know. But it just occurred to me today, what does he do now? It's like, where are they now? So I looked up his YouTube account, which is Tom Wilson on YouTube. I think there's only one as far as I know. And I think his stage name was like Tom F. Wilson. That was what his credit was, is Tom F. Wilson. I used to make fun of my friend whose name was Brian Wilson. I used to call him Brian F. Wilson just because of that movie. But, so he didn't have a very notable career after the Back to the Future. And I'm not saying anything negative about him, but I think he persevered because he stayed in the business. He's taken acting jobs. I think he took movies where he could, and I think he started a stand-up career because he is really hilarious, and his videos on YouTube are really funny to me. He, like when he goes to stand-up places, he'll film a vlog of like what he's doing, and he'll just put in little things, and I think he's quite a bit funnier than me, to tell you the truth. Not that I'm like the gold standard, I'm just saying he's really, really funny. And he'll just have little quips that he'll make, and the one video I was watching was called What Do I Do Now or something like that. Jeez, I can't remember. Short-term memory loss, people. Something like, What Do I Do All Day or something like that. And he says he gets asked a lot what he does. I'm just checking to make sure this is rolling. What he does, and he made a video on YouTube about what he does during the day. And he goes to auditions, and he does filming of movies, and I guess he goes to church, and so he did a video that sort of covers, and he did it very tongue-in-cheek and like with good humor, because he gets asked all the time. Look at this blue sky. Wow, that is freaking awesome. What a great shot. He gets asked all the time, so what else has he done besides Back to the Future? And that in a way is his public legacy as far as his most notable. They always say the term most known for, Tom Wilson, most known for Back to the Future, like that. I don't know what it is with this camera. I switched cameras and I'm having trouble lining this up. So he has done a lot of stuff, as far as I know. over the years. So it's been about, what, 25 something years, 85, 95, 2005, 2015. Yeah, it's about 30 years, right? It's over 30 years since Back to the Future 1. And so he is the epitome of a survivor and a person that has just persevered through life because, I guess because of his attitude. I think that's what you have to have. And go watch his YouTube channel. It's really funny. Tom Wilson. Yeah, so the other thing... It's really tough to sort of collect your mind after, like, you felt like you almost got ran over by a car. You know, the other time I got ran over by a car was, like, right over here somewhere. That's a funny coincidence. This is, like, must be a bad area because, well, I'm just going to speculate and say there's a lot of rich, wealthy, older people that don't drive well, and they come from up north and they retire down here, and they don't know how to route, they don't know how to drive down here because maybe, A, they didn't drive a lot, B, they didn't drive at all, and they lived in the city and they took cabs all their life and they come down here and they don't know how to drive that well. And I'm not targeting any one person trying to generalize, but every time I've almost been ran over, it's been by an elderly person. I don't think I've been run over by a younger person under 50. So it's not that I don't like older people, it's just that I guess we need to sharpen our skills because maybe it's because retired people don't drive as much, so their skills are not honed like people that drive, like, you know, go to work 5 days a week or whatever. And I'm not hating, I'm just stating the obvious. That's one thing that's changing this vlog is I'm not really going to be afraid to sort of let my hair down and relax and just say what's on my mind. That's what I want to do. I think a little bit, I was holding back a little bit trying to be Mr. Perfect on these vlogs. And I'm not Mr. Perfect, I'm just like everybody else. And I get ran over by cars too, just like everybody else does. And I have to wait for traffic just like everybody else does. So my sort of, the moral to the story of my lesson today, wow, these people are driving really fast.
Even though it says 30 miles an hour in this curve right in the road there, it says 30 miles an hour. Let's see if we can get hit by this car.
See if we can get hit by a car right here. Not so lucky. So I like when I hear stories about, or I just, I hear people's experiences about perseverance and being a survivor of life and just pushing through despite whatever things have happened in their life. You know, actors have had things happen too. There's a lot of actors that were popular in the 80s or 90s and then their career just drops off. And I guess we assume they just, you know, sailed into the sunset and were just fine for the rest of life because they made so much money. It makes you wonder about that kind of stuff. Anyway, I didn't want this vlog to be like real long,
but check out this elevator up there. Construction elevator going up the building there. Pretty interesting. Like it's like an exterior elevator, freight elevator, I guess.
So that's the message. It's always just the people, sometimes life is survival. You come to a lot of points in your life where you're just feel like you're just trying to make it day in and day out, but it always seems like, wow, it's very windy right here. It always seems like sometimes there is light at the end of the tunnel. Most of the time there is light at the end of the tunnel, and you just have to survive for a period to get to that period. And I've been to a lot of places in my life that were really terrible. Anyway, like I said, I didn't want this vlog to go on forever and ever, so we'll see you guys later. Got some vlogs that are pending still trying to pump out vlogs, and hope you guys are doing well. Sincerely, I hope things are going well in your life with 2017. We'll see you guys later. Have a good one. Sometimes when that caffeine gets working, I see things and I start thinking of other alternate stories to tell you guys, and it's tough to focus. Like this building over here, I believe was the studio for a very famous sculptor who is very famous. His name is Jack Dowd. I think his office is right there. And I stopped by one day and I somehow saw his name on the thing, and I went in and talked to him, and it was like a huge honor because the stuff he does is like a lot of life-size. He used to have a full-size truck out here, okay? Pickup truck, and it had a dude sitting up against the truck with his knee bent, like, and he looked like he had like a kind of a redneck hat with a smoke or something sticking out. And you'd go by and you'd think it looked like a real guy sitting there. But it was actually a sculpture that he made with a real truck and a guy made out of bronze, I think. So, it smells like pee out here. Are there a lot of people peeing out here?